Well, good afternoon. Boy, look at the crowd we've got. Isn't it exciting? I'm going to do something a little different this year before we start with the program. I want all the elected officials to come forward. I know we got Senator C here. We got Ms. Peterson from East Point, Mayor of East Point. I know that Chairman Eaves is here. Chairman, where are you at? All the elected officials that are here, come forward and be recognized. This is College Park, but let me say, it takes all of us to make it work. I don't see Chairman Eaves. Come on up, Mayor Peterson. Come on up, Councilman. Councilman Karn, come on up. Come on up, Chairman Eaves. Any other elected officials that are here, I want you to be recognized because, yes, we're in College Park, but it takes all the elected officials to make this boat run around. Come on, Catherine. Where's Tracy at? Well, let's gather around. Let's take a picture of all. Where are you on the zone?
You want us to come right straight from the road? That's what I'm talking
Never knew politicians to be shy. I know they're more here than that, but most of the time, if you give them a chance at the camera, they're right up here. I have the honor to honor the first guest this evening. Our first guest is Dr. Stuart Gully. Dr. Gully, would you and your wife come up, please? This is a proclamation, whereas it's a great pleasure the Mayor and Council of City College Park recognize Frank Stuart Gully as a year's citywide Citizen of the Year. Whereas Dr. Gully is most recognized for the 7th President Chief Executive Officer of Woodward Academy, the nation's largest college prep school, 2,800 students and 650 employees. Whereas Dr. Gully continues his strong leadership advocacy for education within the boundaries of College Park community where his family has resided since 2009. Whereas he has long exhibited passion to empower others through active participation in United Methodist Church, North Georgia Conference, Atlanta College Park District, and Atlanta Area Associations of Independent Schools, the Rotary Club, the Atlanta, and most recently has been appointed to the College Park representative as a new founded Airport CID Improvement District and has also been appointed as the Air Tropolis Alliance. Whereas he reached Liberty Works and outreach amplifies the desire to seek solutions and challenges for climates and change for families and values to continue leadership. Now therefore, proclaim Mayor and Council hereby honor Dr. Frank Stuart Gully for his outstanding civil spirit, extraordinary commitment to education, and his devotion to serve the citizens of College Park.
How about the set list thus far tonight? It's fantastic. Having a great time. I certainly am myself. As I mentioned a little while ago earlier before the festivities began musically, the City of College Park, we've initiated what's called the inaugural Employee of the Year program. Essentially, all department directors and leadership involved had the opportunity to recognize and acknowledge various individuals who made meaningful contributions to the City of College Park Corporation and the community at large. With that, Mayor and City Council, along with myself, we all decided that the City Fest venue would be a great opportunity in which to recognize and showcase the talents and many contributions of various employees. We actually have three different awards in relationship to this tonight. We actually have a second runner-up, a first runner-up, and the actual Employee of the Year award. Each of these individuals have been recognized across the board for their many contributions, and what I'd like to do at this time is to talk a little bit about what that is and who they are. So without further ado, the second runner-up is an individual who serves as an administrative professional with the College Park Fire Department. And interestingly enough, this election process was pretty unanimous by the rank and file of the College Park Fire Department. Ms. Theresia Huggins, who I'll be presenting momentarily, she not only represents the College Park Fire Department in the capacity I just described, but she's helped in many various ways, including the budget process, the chief's right-hand person and left-hand person, depending on what the situation is. So I've interacted with her a great deal myself during the last couple years I've been with the City of College Park, and this recognition is most worthy for presentation. With that, I'd like to ask Ms. Theresia Huggins to please come forward as we have an awards presentation to make. Ms. Theresia Huggins, College Park Fire Department, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause for Theresia Huggins, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you all. Appreciate it. At this time, I'd like to acknowledge the first runner-up for the inaugural Employee of the Year program. This individual represents the Department of Information Technology. In the Department of Information Technology, a gentleman by the name of Robert Givens, who functions as a management information specialist. The basis for his recognition is not only his cheery and upbeat disposition, but the fact that he's made many contributions to not only the Department of Information Technology, but the City of College Park as an operation as a whole, including various recycling efforts, consolidations, as well as achieving expanded networking capabilities for the City of College Park and the entire organization. Likewise, his efforts and contributions has led to numerous efficiencies in operations to the entire city operation, and therefore, doing a great job for the taxpayer as a whole. His name, ladies and gentlemen, is Mr. Robert Givens. If I can please have you come forward, sir. And he has this lovely family here as well, so if you all would stand up on his behalf, that would be great. His lovely wife and children are here. Thank you, Mr. Givens, and congratulations. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, again, a pretty competitive process. There are others who were recognized or worthy of recognition. At this time, it's fitting that we have one of our public safety professionals to be recognized as Employee of the Year. In public safety, particularly in the police department, they oftentimes put their lives in danger. And in the process of putting their lives in danger to protect the community, they make tremendous accomplishments and contributions. This particular individual is responsible for the past year of 166 arrests, 58 which were involved in felonies. He also had been able to make successful contributions in the way of investigative techniques, not to mention him being recognized recently as College Park Police Department's Officer of the Year. So given the tremendous accomplishments, the statistics, and the tremendous benchmarking in his accomplishments, It was deemed appropriate that police investigator Rave Hines be recognized for the actual Employee of the Year. With statistics like that, working diligently to keep our community safe and responsive to crime, it's without exception that he be recognized accordingly. So with that, police investigator Rave Hines, if you would please come forward and accept your reward as the College Park Employee of the Year, ladies and gentlemen. Round of applause, please. And he wore his uniform tonight. So that's a good thing. So in case we need him later, hopefully we will not. Hopefully he'll be able to celebrate the accomplishment. Investigator Hines, congratulations, sir. Thank you all very much, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. This will continue to be an annual feature of College Park City Fest. We think it's very appropriate. And for other employees out there who are here tonight, please use this example as a good experience for you to be encouraged as well. With that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much. I hope you all enjoy the show, and thank you very much for being here again. Take care.
Thank you, Mr. Moore.
Good evening, College Park. Everybody having a good time? All right. You know, every year when I do my Citizen of the Year award, I try to have a different criteria. And this year, I thought long and hard, and I've been in College Park for a number of years now, and I've gotten to know a lot of people. And we all love College Park. I know I love College Park. So I thought this year I was going to look around for the person that I know that has deep roots in College Park, and everything they do says, I love College Park. So I would like Ms. Sandy Causey and her husband, Bo, to come up. So we're going to have some more whereases here. Come on over, Sandy. Whereas it was with great pleasure that the Mayor and Council of the City of College Park recognizes Ms. Sandy Causey as this year's Ward 1 Citizen of the Year. And whereas Ms. Causey, a 28-year resident of College Park, is also a native to our area, having attended Central Park Elementary and Russell High School. She has been employed by Chick-fil-A for 33 years. Now remember I said Sandy always shows up. She always volunteers. And frequently, she brings Chick-fil-A goodies. Ms. Causey has woven herself and her family into the fabric of the community she loves, as demonstrated by her genuine commitment and active involvement in her neighborhood and College Park. And whereas she is an active member of the College Park Women's Club and a longtime member of the Historic College Park Neighborhood Association, she served as its third president and was on the committee that created the first block party, which ultimately transformed into what we know today as College Park Arts Festival. And finally, whereas because of her generosity and compassion for all people, she always makes herself available to help where it is needed, regardless of the circumstances. Ms. Causey exemplifies for her actions that we are a community of real people. Now therefore, be it proclaimed that the Mayor and Council do hereby honor Ms. Sandy Causey for her outstanding civic-minded spirit, for her passion and love of and for the people of the community, and her devoted service to the City of College Park. Proclaimed this 23rd day of August, 2014. Thank you.
Councilman Ambrose Clay, ladies and gentlemen. College Park City Council.
Whoa. Uh-oh. All right, how's everybody doing? Good, good. Hope we're enjoying this entertainment. I am here to present my award for the Ward 2 Citizen of the Year. And we're going to ask Mr. Alpha Lewis to come on up at this time, and his family is welcome to come up as well. Now, this is a hard-working community activist, so y'all got to give him a hand as he approaches the stage here. Come on up, bring the kids, grandkids, everybody. Well, I'm glad I didn't damage your award here. Man of the Year. Come on up here, Brother Al. It has Alfred Lewis on here. We all know him as Al in Ward 2. So I'm going to read this proclamation here. I'm going to hand it to you. Let's see. Okay, that's a little better. Whereas it's with great pleasure that the Mayor and Council of College Park recognizes Mr. Alfred Lewis is this year's Ward 2 2014 Citizen of the Year. Hey man, how you doing? All right. Whereas Mr. Lewis has lived and worked in College Park over 3 years and has been active community organizer from the start, and whereas Mr. Lewis is tirelessly engaged in interaction with the residents of Embarcadero Club apartment communities through membership of the CARES team, and whereas Mr. Lewis coordinates the monthly Ward 2 community meetings, which he keeps residents abreast of city events and issues that directly affect them. He also acts as a liaison for Ward 2 activities to include back-to-school giveaways, Christmas for the kids, and public safety forums. And whereas Mr. Lewis sets a standard as a community activist, he personifies what it means to be active in the community by encouraging others to share their thoughts and ideas, values, and experiences, which he believes leads to the natural progression of community improvement. Now, therefore, it be proclaimed that the Mayor and Council do hereby honor Mr. Alfred Lewis for his outstanding civic-minded spirit, extraordinary commitment to the citizens of his community, and his devoted service to the City of College Park, proclaimed this 23rd day of August, 2014. Brother Al, we can't thank you enough. We appreciate you. We appreciate everything that you do.
Good evening. So I follow protocol here and introduce my Citizen of the Year for Ward 3. Mr. Ken Allen, if you and your wife will come up. Put my glasses on here, I don't turn over forward. Uh-oh! I'm glad we paid for them. We'll let that sit over there. Ken, congratulations. It's certainly an honor to introduce Ken and honor him as being the Citizen of the Year for Ward 3. Ken has been around over 20 years as a resident and actually been here in this community since 1966 working at Delta Airlines. So it's my pleasure to give this honor to Mr. Ken Allen, where it is with great pleasure that the Mayor and Council of the City of College Park recognize Ken Allen as this year Ward 3 2014 Citizen of the Year. And whereas Mr. Allen has been a Ward 3 resident for more than 21 years and has been an illustrious career with Delta Airlines. And whereas Mr. Allen has been vested in the community, serving as College Park Councilman of Ward 3 in 2003, as well as serving on the College Park Board of Zoning Appeals and the College Park Housing Authority Board. And currently serving on the, this guy's a server, serving on the Board of Directors for the new College Park Destination Marketing Organization, which creates and generates economic development and promotes tourism in the City of College Park. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that the Mayor and Council do by honor Mr. Ken Allen for his outstanding civic-minded spirit and his insight in helping to shape the city of College Park. Proclaim this 23rd day of August, Mayor and Council of the City of College Park.
Thank you, I appreciate it. This is your night, citizens of College Park and friends of College Park, so enjoy the night, have a good time. Music is fantastic.
And we also like to present his wife with this something that I almost broke. Well, we'll present her that award. Thank you very much. Let's pose for some people. Also, we will now honor the Ward 4 Citizen of the Year. Councilman Phillips is not with us this evening, but I'd like to bring up his son, Tony. Tony Phillips, if you'll come up. Miss Eleanor Cornelius and your family, whoever would like to come up, will you please come up, please?
Good evening. How's everybody doing this evening? Councilman Phillips couldn't be here. It's always a pleasure for me to stand in. It's an honor for me to stand in for my dad, and I certainly want to share with him in honoring Miss Eleanor Cornelius as her and her loved ones make their way up onto the stage. Anytime a community like College Park, what makes it so special are the people, and it's folks like this that we want to take the time to recognize. Whereas, it is with great pleasure that the Mayor and City Council of the City of College Park recognizes Ms. Eleanor Cornelius as this year's Ward 4 2014 Citizen of the Year, and whereas Ms. Cornelius has been a Ward 4 resident for more than 30 years, she is committed to assisting her neighbors and others in the community. As a retired educator, she exhibits her passion for educating children as a substitute teacher in the neighborhood elementary school, and whereas she has served as neighborhood watch captain to assistant poll manager in local elections, her community spirit extends beyond our boundaries through her work with her church, Albany State Alumni Association, South Fulton Retired Educators, and Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority, Incorporated. And whereas Ms. Cornelius has enthusiastically served as the volunteer chairperson for both the 2013 and the 2014 annual City Fest, and whereas Ms. Cornelius was appointed to the College Park Business and Industry Development Authority this past January based on her commitment to attain development and promote the general welfare of the community of College Park. Now, therefore, be it proclaimed that the Mayor and City Council do hereby honor Ms. Eleanor Cornelius, proclaimed this 23rd day of August, 2014.
Before she started talking, we're certainly going to let, I guess, one of your sisters or somebody come up and hold that.
Good evening. It's always a pleasure to volunteer in the great city of College Park, Georgia. Let's give our city a round of applause. The best city in Fulton County and around the world, College Park, Georgia. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
How about a big round of applause for all our recipients tonight, y'all? Give them some love.